I just came to Stony Brook as of a year ago. There are a lot more diverse shark species here than I realized, and so Stony Brook was a great opportunity for me to come and study sharks.
The reason why we're researching here, which is the New York Bight off of Long Island, is because we're trying to really understand all of the species that we're researching and understand, you know, why are they here, why are they utilizing this habitat.
We actually really don't know that much about sharks here in Long Island, but our group, the Frisk Lab and Shipley Lab, have been studying and tagging sharks for the last 10, 15 years.
Small sandbar or dusky?
That's a hammerhead.
Wait, oh, hammerhead.
No, that's a hammerhead.
It's really quite fantastic. We can see anything from sandbar spinners, sand tigers, duskies. We even see black tips. We get hammerheads, three different species of hammerheads, and then whites and porpoises in colder waters.
So I don't know if it's a great, but that's the biggest hammerhead I've seen yet.
Quite a fantastic distribution of species we get here.
37.3.
We started off today, we went over to the San Diego wreck and we were fishing there for sharks. We ended up getting a bunch of hammerheads, which was pretty fantastic. Our overall hammerhead count is less than four, and we had two in one day.
Got a shark on the line, trying to keep it on the line so we can take our samples.
Big fish.
We have one type of tag called an acoustic tag. It uses sound frequencies to send a signal from a transmitter to a receiver so that we can know if sharks are in the area. And so we'll catch a shark, bring it to the side of the boat, and then surgically implant the acoustic tag, and then sew them back up, do a little bit of a workup, and send them on their way.
No grading. He wants to go.
What a release.
What a release.
That was
nice.
Beautiful release.
So with the acoustic tags, it just passively transmits to all the devices we have on the south shore of Long Island here.
You can get the depth that the shark is swimming at, you can get the ambient water temperature that the shark is swimming around, you can get acceleration data so you can infer behavior of the shark or how fast it's swimming, how much energy it's expending. You can actually get a lot of information and can tailor the tags to kind of the questions that you are asking.
We do this thing called stable isotope analysis. We can look at carbon and nitrogen values and determine things like diet, habitat use, and more.
In the long run, we can help protect them. So we're understanding where they're spending a lot of their time, so we can make that areas that we watch and keep fishermen away from to keep their populations high and making sure that the habitat and ecosystem is as healthy as we can possibly keep it.
I think we're just learning a lot about them, which is important for not only their management as a species and keeping their populations healthy, but also just understanding kind of what are the areas that they're utilizing the most so that it can inform beachgoers for how we can better coexist with them.
What I like to say to most people is that you're more likely to die from a vending machine falling on you than from being bitten by a shark. There's no reason to be afraid. And additionally, sharks are just trying to survive and hang out, get their food, and live their life. We're in their home, so we gotta be respectful of that.
That was a nice, healthy sandbar there. We got an acoustic tag in there. We got all the samples we needed off of it.
Nice.
There you go. Swam off nice and healthy. Hopefully we'll see her on the array at some point later in the year and for many years to come.
Well done, guys. I'm